Hey there! James here! Welcome to our YouTube channel Kids Bedtime Stories! Please hit the like and subscribe button, if you want more of these contents! Now enjoy your bedtime story! The Easter Bunny.
Pasquale, otherwise known as the Easter Bunny, loved the cool air, budding flowers, chirping birds, even the rain in the springtime. He especially loved his special job of preparing for Easter. He was always very happy, even when he was in up to his ear tips, in colorful dyes of pinks, purples, blues, and greens. Even when there was Easter basket grass everywhere. Even when his fur was sticky from all the chocolate bunnies he had made. Pasquale, Pasquale, did you hear? There is going to be snow on Easter this year. Whiskers, Pasquale's best bunny friend, was frantic as he told Pasquale the news. Whiskers, Whiskers, cold, snow and ice will make Easter delivery not very nice, Pasquale replied. Pasquale, you see, had always delivered all the candy through a tunnel system that he and his father, and his father's father, and his father's father's father, all Easter bunnies, had developed throughout the years. All of Pasquale's bunny friends would help deliver the candy through this tunnel. They would arrive at each home through their bunny burrow, just in time to deliver their baskets to each and every child. Pasquale didn't know what to do. He was so sick with worry, that he even started having a hard time packaging all of the Easter baskets in his normal happy mood. No, Pasquale didn't feel very happy. He felt very worried. So worried, in fact, that he felt like just climbing into his burrow and going to sleep until Easter Sunday was over. And he would have to, if it wasn't for Whiskers. "What will I do?" Pasquale complained to Whiskers. "There is no way to deliver these baskets we've made. No way to deliver these candies and treats. No way to deliver if it snows on Easter. No way to deliver, it's never been done. I can't do it. Oh, this is not fun." Whiskers turned to his friend, who was normally very happy, thumped his foot two times, and thought, thought, and thought. "Now Pasquale, you listen to me. You can do this, you can. You will deliver this candy." Pasquale just stared, and he worried some more. "I can't do it, I can't. It hasn't been done before. Who cares if it has been done?" Whiskers said to his friend. "You can do it, you can. There's a reason, you see. There's a reason that you are the Easter Bunny." Now Pasquale, he wanted to believe that Whiskers was right, but he just couldn't see it. "Whiskers, oh Whiskers, you don't understand. It's never been done, I don't know if I can." Pasquale's ears were now bent and flopping to the side. Pasquale did not feel very happy inside. "Pasquale, Pasquale, let's take a moment now to think. If we can't get there through the burrows, what can we do different?" Whiskers asked. One of Pasquale's floppy ears perked up at the suggestion. "Whiskers, oh Whiskers, I'm scared, don't you see? What if I can't deliver the candy?" "Pasquale, Pasquale, you listen to me. You can do this. You can. You just wait and see." Whiskers, he thumped his foot and he thumped some more as he thought. "Whiskers, you're right. I can't let them down. I can't be the reason all those little kids frown." So Pasquale and Whiskers stayed up half the night, trying to think about a new way to get the baskets to the children in the snow. "We could bring shovels?" Whiskers shouted. "Or a heater. Maybe we could melt the snow." Pasquale shook his head from side to side. "If only I could think of something, I'd feel more happy inside. Let's think. Bunnies, they burrow. They have long ears and feet. They have whiskers and..." Whiskers was listing his thoughts, when all of a sudden Pasquale screamed. "That's it? Whiskers, you're a genius. Why didn't I see it before? Bunnies aren't just known for their burrows, but their happiness and much more. Oh Whiskers, you are such a good friend. I was scared and worried to no end. You stayed here beside me. You worked through the night. Oh Whiskers, you are such a delight. There may be a reason I am the Easter Bunny like you say, but you are my friend in the same exact way. Pasquale, Pasquale, hop to it, off you go. And if ever you need me, your friend Whiskers will know." Now Pasquale was thankful for his friend's help and advice, but now it was Easter morning. Since they had been up the whole night planning, Pasquale didn't have a chance to clean his fur before setting out to deliver the candy. So Pasquale hopped from one end of the world to the next, with his baskets, hoppily all the way. It's true, many people say, that year, even though it's a blur, an Easter bunny was seen with colorful fur. And if ever again Pasquale would doubt, in his own words he said, "I'd give Whiskers a shout." Pasquale happily made all his deliveries despite the snow. It was a very happy Easter for all the boys and girls. Pasquale, otherwise known as the Easter Bunny, loved the cool air, budding flowers, chirping birds, even the rain in the springtime. He especially loved his special job of preparing for Easter. He was always very happy, even when he was in up to his ear tips, in colorful dyes of pinks, purples, blues, and greens. Even when there was Easter basket grass everywhere. Even when his fur was sticky from all the chocolate bunnies he had made. Pasquale, Pasquale, did you hear? There is going to be snow on Easter this year. Whiskers, Pasquale's best bunny friend, was frantic as he told Pasquale the news. Whiskers, Whiskers, cold, snow and ice, will make Easter delivery not very nice. Pasquale replied. Pasquale, you see, had always delivered all the candy through a tunnel system that he and his father, and his father's father, and his father's father's father, all Easter bunnies, had developed throughout the years. All of Pasquale's bunny friends would help deliver the candy through this tunnel. They would arrive at each home through their bunny burrow, just in time to deliver their baskets to each and every child. Pasquale didn't know what to do. He was so sick with worry, that he even started having a hard time packaging all of the Easter baskets in his normal happy mood. No, Pasquale didn't feel very happy. He felt very worried. So worried, in fact, that he felt like just climbing into his burrow and going to sleep until Easter Sunday was over. And he would have to, if it wasn't for Whiskers. "What will I do?" Pasquale complained to Whiskers. "There is no way to deliver these baskets we've made. No way to deliver these candies and treats. No way to deliver if it snows on Easter. No way to deliver, it's never been done. I can't do it. Oh, this is not fun." Whiskers turned to his friend, who was normally very happy, thumped his foot two times, and thought, thought, and thought. "Now Pasquale, you listen to me. You can do this, you can. You will deliver this candy." Pasquale just stared, and he worried some more. "I can't do it, I can't. It hasn't been done before. Who cares if it has been done?" Whiskers said to his friend. "You can do it, you can. There's a reason, you see. There's a reason that you are the Easter Bunny." Now Pasquale, he wanted to believe that Whiskers was right, but he just couldn't see it. "Whiskers, oh Whiskers, you don't understand. It's never been done, I don't know if I can." Pasquale's ears were now bent and flopping to the side. Pasquale did not feel very happy inside. "Pasquale, Pasquale, let's take a moment now to think. If we can't get there through the burrows, what can we do different?" Whiskers asked. One of Pasquale's floppy ears perked up at the suggestion. "Whiskers, oh Whiskers, I'm scared, don't you see? What if I can't deliver the candy?" "Pasquale, Pasquale, you listen to me. You can do this. You can. You just wait and see." Whiskers, he thumped his foot and he thumped some more as he thought. "Whiskers, you're right. I can't let them down. I can't be the reason all those little kids frown." So Pasquale and Whiskers stayed up half the night, trying to think about a new way to get the baskets to the children in the snow. "We could bring shovels?" Whiskers shouted. "Or a heater. Maybe we could melt the snow." Pasquale shook his head from side to side. "If only I could think of something, I'd feel more happy inside. Let's think. Bunnies, they burrow. They have long ears and feet. They have whiskers and..." Whiskers was listing his thoughts, when all of a sudden Pasquale screamed. "That's it? Whiskers, you're a genius. Why didn't I see it before? Bunnies aren't just known for their burrows, but their happiness and much more. Oh Whiskers, you are such a good friend. I was scared and worried to no end. You stayed here beside me. You worked through the night. Oh Whiskers, you are such a delight. There may be a reason I am the Easter Bunny like you say, but you are my friend in the same exact way. Pasquale, Pasquale, hop to it, off you go. And if ever you need me, your friend Whiskers will know. Now Pasquale was thankful for his friend's help and advice, but now it was Easter morning. Since they had been up the whole night planning, Pasquale didn't have a chance to clean his fur before setting out to deliver the candy. So Pasquale hopped from one end of the world to the next, with his baskets, hoppily all the way. It's true many people say, that year even though it's a blur, an Easter bunny was seen with colorful fur. And if ever again Pasquale would doubt, in his own words he said, I'd give Whiskers a shout. Pasquale happily made all his deliveries despite the snow. It was a very happy Easter for all the boys and girls. Pasquale, otherwise known as the Easter Bunny, loved the cool air, budding flowers, chirping birds, even the rain in the springtime. He especially loved his special job of preparing for Easter. He was always very happy, even when he was in up to his ear tips, in colorful dyes of pinks, purples, blues, and greens. Even when there was Easter basket grass everywhere. Even when his fur was sticky from all the chocolate bunnies he had made. Pasquale, Pasquale, did you hear? There is going to be snow on Easter this year. Whiskers, Pasquale's best bunny friend, was frantic as he told Pasquale the news. Whiskers, Whiskers, cold, snow and ice, will make Easter delivery not very nice. Pasquale replied. Pasquale, you see, had always delivered all the candy through a tunnel system that he and his father, and his father's father, and his father's father's father, all Easter bunnies, had developed throughout the years. All of Pasquale's bunny friends would help deliver the candy through this tunnel. They would arrive at each home through their bunny burrow, just in time to deliver their baskets to each and every child. Pasquale didn't know what to do. He was so sick with worry, that he even started having a hard time packaging all of the Easter baskets in his normal happy mood. No, Pasquale didn't feel very happy. He felt very worried. So worried, in fact, that he felt like just climbing into his burrow and going to sleep until Easter Sunday was over. And he would have to, if it wasn't for Whiskers. What will I do? Pasquale complained to Whiskers. There is no way to deliver these baskets we've made. No way to deliver these candies and treats. No way to deliver if it snows on Easter. No way to deliver, it's never been done. I can't do it. Oh, this is not fun. Whiskers turned to his friend, who was normally very happy, thumped his foot two times, and thought, thought, and thought. Now Pasquale, you listen to me. You can do this, you can. You will deliver this candy. Pasquale just stared, and he worried some more. I can't do it, I can't. It hasn't been done before. Who cares if it has been done? Whiskers said to his friend. You can do it, you can. There's a reason, you see. There's a reason that you are the Easter Bunny. Now Pasquale, he wanted to believe that Whiskers was right, but he just couldn't see it. Whiskers, oh Whiskers, you don't understand. It's never been done, I don't know if I can. Pasquale's ears were now bent and flopping to the side. Pasquale did not feel very happy inside. Pasquale, Pasquale, let's take a moment now to think. If we can't get there through the burrows, what can we do different? Whiskers asked. One of Pasquale's floppy ears perked up at the suggestion. Whiskers, oh Whiskers, I'm scared, don't you see? What if I can't deliver the candy? Pasquale, Pasquale, you listen to me. You can do this. You can. You just wait and see. Whiskers, he thumped his foot and he thumped some more as he thought. Whiskers, you're right. I can't let them down. I can't be the reason all those little kids frown. So Pasquale and Whiskers stayed up half the night, trying to think about a new way to get the baskets to the children in the snow. We could bring shovels? Whiskers shouted. Or a heater. Maybe we could melt the snow. Pasquale shook his head from side to side. If only I could think of something, I'd feel more happy inside. Let's think. Bunnies, they burrow. They have long ears and feet. They have whiskers and... Whiskers was listing his thoughts, when all of a sudden Pasquale screamed. That's it? Whiskers, you're a genius. Why didn't I see it before? Bunnies aren't just known for their burrows, but their happiness and much more. Oh Whiskers, you are such a good friend. I was scared and worried to no end. You stayed here beside me. You worked through the night. Oh Whiskers, you are such a delight. There may be a reason I am the Easter Bunny like you say, but you are my friend in the same exact way. Pasquale, Pasquale, hop to it, off you go. And if ever you need me, your friend Whiskers will know. Now Pasquale was thankful for his friend's help and advice, but now it was Easter morning. Since they had been up the whole night planning, Pasquale didn't have a chance to clean his fur before setting out to deliver the candy. So Pasquale hopped from one end of the world to the next, with his baskets, happily all the way. It's true many people say, that year even though it's a blur, an Easter bunny was seen with colorful fur. And if ever again Pasquale would doubt, in his own words he said, I'd give Whiskers a shout. Pasquale happily made all his deliveries despite the snow. It was a very happy Easter for all the boys and girls.